Hello, good morning students. So we are again here with a new chapter. We are not afraid to die if we can all be together. This is for class 11th, Hornbill. The book name is Hornbill, chapter number 2. We are not afraid to die if we can all be together. The title itself is saying very much. The title is explaining the core essence of the chapter, and it was written by Captain Gordon Cook and Alan East. This is about a boat and a journey, or you can say sea voyage. So here in the chapter, these pictures are being described, like the routes of Captain Cook's voyage, where he had been going, and this is their boat. And they had named their boat as Wave Walker. About the writers, Gordon Cook was born on December 3, 1978 in Toronto, is a two-time Canadian Olympic sailor. He sails for the Royal Canadian Yacht Club. He is the son of Stephen Cook and Linda Cook. He had a great interest in writing stories too. And Alan East was admitted to the role of solicitors in 2003 and has gained extensive experience as a litigator, manager and legal trainer. In 2010, Alan joined Coventry University as a senior lecturer in law. These are the important words and phrases which are being used in the chapter. Voyage, a long journey by sea or space. Morning means sharpening. Seafaring, regularly traveling by sea. Honing seafaring skills, improving the skills required to travel by sea. Zib, a triangular sail that sets ahead of the foremast in a ship. Knots, a unit of speed equal to 1 nautical mile per hour, used especially for ships, aircraft or vents. Mooring, the rope, chains or anchors by or to which a boat, ship or buoy is moored. Stump, the part of a ship or a boat. Oil skins, heavy cotton clothes, waterproof with oil. Capsizing, be overturned in water, taut, stressed or pulled tightly. Boom, a pole that controls the angle and shape of the sail. Keel, steel structure along the base of the ship. Penprings, ocean, rigging, hull, sextant, etc. Story, let's come to the story. And the theme of the chapter is optimism is very much important for us. And when we are in difficult situation or difficult circumstances, we always should keep faith that everything will go upright with the proper faith and trust, and with the passage of time you will get your ambition and your desire, but if you are optimistic and thinking positively. In July 1976, the narrator, his wife Mary, son Jonathan and daughter Suzanne set sail from Plymouth, England to duplicate the round the world voyage made. The same has been made by Captain James Cook before 200 years. They took the voyage in their professionally built ship, the Wave Walker. They had named their boat as Wave Walker. Accompanied by two experienced sailors, they had taken the help of two experienced sailors, Larry Wiesel and American Herb Sisler, a Swiss, to tackle one of the world's roughest seas, the Southern Indian Ocean. The first part of the journey, that is about 1,500 kilometers up to Cape Town, passed smoothly and pleasantly. But on the second day of Cape Town, they had to face strong gales. But gales were not worrying them. Gales did not worry the narrator. He was worried about the size of the waves, which were alarming. up to 15 meters as high as the mainmast. On 25th December, the Raitur ship was in the southern Indian Ocean, 3500 kilometers to the east of Cape Town. The family celebrated their new year on board the ship. At dawn on, the family celebrated their new year on the ship. New Year and 25th December, both they had enjoyed in a hope that soon the atmosphere will go up right. The dawn on January 2nd, the waves were gigantic. Unfriendly weather and gigantic waves compelled the sailors to slow their speed and to drop a storm zip and to take other precautions too, so that they can save themselves. The danger was so obvious that the sailors completed life raft drill, attached lifelines and life jackets because they could see the dangerous situations. So they need to use all the precautions. That's why they had completed their life raft drill. They had attached themselves with the ropes, with the lifelines, and wore properly their life jackets. Suddenly at 6 p.m., a tremendous explosion shook the wave walker, and the author was thrown overboard. The ship was about to capsize. They could see that their ship was just about to capsize when another gigantic wave hit it, tossing it upright once again. The author was thrown back onto the deck, his head and ribs smashing against the walls. In spite of his injuries, the narrator took charge of the situation. Somehow, he found the wheel, lined up the stem for the next wave. In spite of his injuries, in that explosion, the narrator got injured badly. But there was an optimistic feelings in his mind that he was very much, alert, and he wanted to save the life of their family members and the crew member. So he tried his best to find the wheel, lined up the stem for the next wave, and hung on till Mary appeared. He was waiting there till he saw his wife Mary and took charge of the wheel. He handed over the charge of the wheel to Mary. Larry and Herb started pumping out water like madmen. They were working very hard. They wanted to pump out the water from their ship. The whole starboard side means, I have told you in the chapter, the right side of the ship burst inward. It was coming inside. It was looking like it was coming inside. The narrator managed to cover canvas across the gaps to prevent water. Then the problem in front of the narrator was that he wanted to cover all the gaps so that they can stop water from entering into the ship. Then came more problems. Their hand pumps, which Larry and Herb were using, stopped working, and electric pumps got short-circuited. Fortunately, the narrator found a spare means extra electric pump. Where he found that? Under the chart room that started working. The entire night was spent in pumping, steering, repairing and sending radio signals. The narrator was trying his best to send radio signals to the outer world so that they could get help from the outer world. But because they were in a rural area, the signals were not working properly, so they could not connect to Mayday calls. The word Mayday calls is in there in your chapter. The narrator checked charts and calculated that Isle Amsterdam, a French scientific base, was their only hope. When the narrator went into the chart room, he found that they could not row their boat to Australia, as it was their next destination. They wanted to go to Australia, but the condition of the boat was not allowing them that they could start their journey towards Australia. So the narrator need to check where they could land or stop their journey right now. So after checking and calculating the wind speed and all, he found that nearly few kilometers, like 100 kilometers and all, there was an island which was actually a French scientific base. That name was Isle Amsterdam. Sue and Joan were injured, but they said they were not afraid to die. Now, in the difficult situation, the narrator went to the room of their children to know whether they are okay. So he found that Sue, his daughter, was badly injured, but they did not wanted to bother their father, and they said they were not afraid to die if they can all be together. These are the essence and important words of the line and said by Joan, who was a 6 year small boy. And when his father asked them, are you people afraid or feeling some seriousness, or what are you feeling nervous, then Joan said, Papa, we are not afraid if we are together, you, Sue, mommy and me. Sue's head was swollen and she had a deep injury. The narrator became more determined seeing his children's courage. The narrator had no words. He was speechless. He became speechless when he heard the courageous and motivational words from his 6-year-old boy. And he determined himself that he would do his best to save the life of all the members. Finally, they reached Isle Amsterdam, a volcanic island, where they were welcomed by 28 inhabitants. 28 inhabitants were living there. Thus, the collective strength and never-failing optimism of the sailors made it possible for them to come out of the jaws of death. They could come out from the death because of their optimistic or positive feelings and the strength and the courage of the small children. Though Jonathan and Suzanne did not do anything to save Waywalker, but their courage, forbearance, faith and optimism gave extra strength and persistence to the narrator and his team. The bravery of the strong-willed children is noteworthy in this story. The bravery of the strong-willed children. The children were having very much a strong will, willpower. That is absolutely worth praising. These are the main characters. Narrator, a 37-year-old businessman who had a dream to sail around the world and replicate Captain Cook's voyage. He spent 16 years honing his seafaring skills to finally embark on a voyage and achieve his dream of sailing in British waters. Mary, the wife of the narrator, a courageous woman, she supports her husband's dream of sailing and is always ready to face any adversity. Jonathan, the 6-year-old son of the narrator, a little boy with great wisdom, who understands the importance of family and wishes to be together even if they all die. Suzanne, narrator's 7-year-old daughter, who displays patience and perseverance. She endures pain and remains silent. She doesn't want to add to her father's troubles. She understands the gravity of the situation and behaves in a manner much beyond her age. Larry Wiesel, an American crewman who helped the narrator to tackle the rough southern Indian Ocean. Herb Sizzler, a Swiss crewman who helped the narrator to tackle the rough southern Indian Ocean. The theme, the story We Are Not Afraid to Die, shows how unity, teamwork, and an indomitable spirit helps to overcome the toughest of situations. The family members trust the narrator and their faith in him boosts his confidence to keep going against all odds. The story also shows the struggle of a father determined to save his family, who leaves no stone unturned to bring the situation under control. In this story, all the characters are brave and love each other immensely. The little boy Jonathan exhibits a great courage and is also ready to die if all his family members are together. All that matters is that they are together. That was important for them, that they were together. The young girl Suzanne is seriously injured but chooses not to add to her father's worries. She did not want to worry her father because of her problems, who is struggling to save everyone. The story beautifully highlights the struggle of each member of the family and the combined efforts of all the members that help them to survive in such adverse conditions. This is the character sketch of the narrator. 37-year-old businessman, he was a man of great courage and conviction. He proved himself as a great captain and responsible father during the challenging and trying times after the irreparable damage done to Wave Walker by keeping his composure and face. All lives on the boat could be saved because of his seafaring skills. His presence of mind and timely decision helped them survive through the stormy ordeal. It was a wise decision on his part to hire two professionals, Larry Wiesel and Herb Sizzler, to help them tackle the Southern Indian Ocean. Ultimately, the narrator made complex calculations and set the course accordingly, which helped them to reach Isle Amsterdam, a French scientific base. This is the picture of Isle Amsterdam. Justify the title of the story. You can note down these lines. The person without a purpose is like a ship without a rudder. Thomas Carlyle. Thank you. Have a nice day. You can note down the important points from the slides. And do write me if your suggestions. If you feel that I need to do some correction and improvement in that, do write me.